So he turns into some kind of torture chair? As if living with Engo isn't torture enough.
Hey, what's up, my peoples? Emgo here, the freaking geek himself, and today we will be reviewing the Mastermind Creations Anarchist! So here we are, and there he is, and first and foremost, as always, we'll take a quick look at the packaging. So right here you have Anarchist looking all anarch-like. I don't know. Right here you have R16 Anarchist with a picture of him on the other side. Yeah, the same thing. Of course, you can open the front flap here. Reveal a little piece of artwork there of Anarchist and his little drone buddy. And here is where the figure sits, reformatted. On the back of the box, you have your obligatory product shot. He does this, that, the other, all that cool stuff. And that's basically it for the packaging. And included in the packaging is the obligatory third-party collector's card right there with Anarchist and his little drone dude. And you have his tech specs, if that interests you. Woo! Cards. And you do get the instructions / comic book right here, which is standard for Mastermind, so you have that as well. And there you go. So moving right along, here we have Anarchist, which is Mastermind Creations' take on IDW K-On! From the DJD. And yes, more IDW designs. Keep bringing them on. You know I love them. Keep bringing them on. Can somebody get on a Rodimus, please? Why hasn't anybody given us an IDW Rodimus? Come on, it makes too much sense to not do, people. Come on. Somebody give us a Rodimus. Really, it just seems like common sense to me. I don't know. But anyway, here we have Anarchist, or K-On!, and as you can see, he turns into an electric chair, like a torture chair, and just that alone, just the novelty of that alone makes this figure really cool, because how many Transformers turn into a torture chair? Only one that I know of, and it's right here. And that's pretty cool. So, let's get in close here so you can see the details. You know, the detailing itself is pretty sparse. There's not a lot of paint on it. Right here on the seat itself, you can see there's actually some molded detail there, and some nice paintwork also. It doesn't look comfortable at all, but then again, it's a torture chair. It's not supposed to be comfortable, but yeah, a little bit of molded detail right here. Again, some of that paintwork all the way down here to the footrest here. Nicely done. You do get some silver on the side, a little bit of gold. You get some silver right here on the treads. The treads don't roll or anything. You do get these bits right here, picked out in silver. He does have visible hand syndrome, unfortunately. I wish they kind of folded away somehow instead of just kind of hanging out there, but it is what it is. And you get some more gold here as well. There you have that. You can see where his gun stores. It just kind of plugs into his crotch right here, and it actually has tabs on either side that keep the arms together, which is quite clever. So you have that. And, yeah, this chair actually does have articulation. You have a double hinge right there, so you can kind of take this and angle it how you like. This bit right here is on a hinge as well. It only goes down this far, but you can kind of raise it up more if you want. The footrest right here is actually on three joints. You have a joint right up top. You have a joint right here, and you have a joint right here, so you can kind of take this and angle it however you wish. The little grabby arms are each on a ball joint at the base, so you have full range of movement there. Pretty good range of movement. Right there, it can move all the way in. And you do have a hinge right here with full range of movement. You can see you can close them all the way up if you want. There you have that. The little cap up top does have a hinge right here, as well as a hinge right here. There is a hinge right here, and the cap itself is on a ball joint. So you get that going on, so you have a chair with articulation. Who'd have thunk? So you have that. Now, as far as figures that can sit in there, I mean, we can take Voss here, and Voss can sit in here pretty well, pretty comfortably. You can just take that and put it on his head right there. Now, granted, he does have a bit of a backpack, so he can't sit flush against the backrest there, but, you know, you can still sit him in there pretty well. And you can take another figure, you can take, like, you know, Spectre here, because he needs to have some sense shocked into him, and kind of put little grabby arms around him, hold him in place right there, put the cap on him. There you go. And that's just fun. I mean, really, that's just fun. Just kind of, you know, see what figures you can get in the chair and, you know, torture them. So there you go. Now, as far as other Transformers, basically this will accommodate a deluxe. Voyagers are way too big for this. But for the most part, you can fit a deluxe in there. Of course, you'll have varying degrees of success depending on, you know, how much backpack they have, how much junk they kind of have hanging off of them. But you can play around with that and, you know, come up with some fun ways to torture your robots. But there you go. So let's get right down to transformation, shall we? Let's. So he does have a third mode, which is pretty much kind of a fan mode. I don't think he actually used this in the comics at all. But we will show off how this works. So first thing you want to do is you want to pop off these little grabby claws here, put them off to the side. What? Transforming worst toy ever. Stop it. You want to untab these side pieces right here. See, they plug right into those tabs. This side has broken on me, and it looks like it just broke again. I glued it back on, but it broke on me. Yeah, unfortunately, on this side, the tab was just way, way, way too tight. You can see where it goes right in there. And the tab was way too tight, and when I went to, you know, untab it, I just pulled the thing off entirely. I glued it back on and thought it was good, but apparently not. I have watched other reviews of this guy, and I haven't seen anybody else have this problem, so it could just be a case of I had bad luck, you know. Like I always say, QC happens. It happens to everybody. Unfortunately, I was the victim of it this time, but, you know. That's life, as Frank Sinatra says. That's life. That's what all the people say. You're right. High in April, shot down in May. Anyway, so let's get right down to the transformation. So again, you're going to untab those side pieces here. And now you're going to take the leg and just straighten it out all the way like that. I don't know if you hear the police sirens outside. This is a legal chair. This is a legal chair, okay? I am legally allowed to torture people in my own home. That's not true at all. That's not, you're not allowed to legally, there's no legal way to torture people. No, that's not right. That's not right. Anyway. So, after you've straightened the leg out, you want to take this piece and rotate it around like that. And then you want to untab the foot. So here's a little tab that goes into that slot right there. Keep that in place like that. And you just bring this all out. The treads, you want to split in half like that, and then you want to bring this around, and you want to rotate it around like that. It's on a double hinge right here. You have to swing it around, and then bring it up, and I don't know if you can see it, but there's, turn it to this side. This post right here will go into that port right there, and this will go right in there. So you just take that, line that up, push it in, and there you go. And on this side, you're going to take this, and again, you have this double hinge here. You just kind of want to take it and rotate it around like that, and then bring it up, and then it will also peg into post right there. Just kind of squeeze it all together, and there you go. Second verse, same as the first, just straighten this out like that, and then you just bring this around like that, bring the foot down, just kind of get all this out of the way here. Then you want to split the tread right here, and then you just rotate around, swing it around, push that into the tab, clear your throat, excuse me, and then you want to do the same thing over here, just rotate that around, swing it up, peg that on. And there you go. So you have the bottom part done. You want to take the arms and untab them from the gun here. Come on. Come on. Come on. There you go. And you can see how those tabs just plug in right there hold everything in place, take the gun, pull it out of his crotch. That's awkward. And, push that back in. You're going to take this whole assembly here and just going to swing it back and just bring the arms back. And you'll see there are tabs that will go into the slots right there. So just bring those up. Bring that up. Just bring all that down like that. You take these panels here and flip them down like that. And now you're going to take the legs and you're going to bring them out and then swing them around like that. So this hinge bends forward like that. That's the proper orientation. So do that. And then you can take this section here and rotate it. Just bring it to the forefront here. Flip out this bit right here, which is actually the heel spur. Flip that out. And bring this forward. And that makes a claw right there. Second vest, same as the first. Just bring that around. Rotate it. Like that. Bring that forward. Rotate. Flip out the heel. Bring that around right there. Like that. Oops. Make sure you have everything has its clearance here. There we go. It's a little snug when you try to get them into this mode. There you go. Then you just kind of curl this up like that. You take the little grabby claws here and you want to rotate the legs around like that, and they will tab in right here to the back. Right? Am I doing this right? Okay, there we go. Tab those in there as legs. Rotate, rotate. Tab that in. Like that. There we go. It compressed a little bit. That's why it was a little more snug than it should have been. There we go. And once you've done that, you take the gun. And there's a port right up here. Just take it, plug it in. And there you have a scorpion mode, which is weird, but it kind of works. It kind of works. It kind of works. Of course, you know, you have those multiple hinges there, so you can pretty much do whatever you want with the tail. The legs have the same amount of articulation. The arms, you know, the claws right here, you have downward movement, a little bit of upward movements, and you have a little bit of use of this joint right here. You can rotate them, and you can open and close the claws. You have these bits right here, you know, basically kind of like mandibles or whatever. You know, those are on hinges. So, yeah, it's weird. Scorpion thing. Sure, why not? Dare I say, why not? So there you have that. So let's get down to robot mode. So again, you want to take these and pop them off, put them off to the side. And then from here, you're just going to take the legs. Let me raise the camera up a little bit so I have room to operate. So you want to take the legs, straighten them back out, rotate them. Bring it down like that, so this painted detail is facing forward. You know you have it right. Rotate the leg right there under the knee. And then you just bring that heel spur out all the way. The foot, this joint right here is a double joint right here. You just want to bring the foot in like that to close it all up. There you got a foot done. There you got a leg all done. Second verse, same as the first. Just straighten that all out. Rotate, bring it down. Rotate, bring up that heel, fold up that foot, and there you got the legs all done, like that, and then you just bring his arms down, right here. You can take these and angle them out. Now for the backpack, you want to bring this out first, and then get his head out. It's easier, just kind of push it out from the bottom here, and then grab it from the top and pull it up. The joint on mine is a little snug. So bring out the head, rotate it, and then you bring the little cap down. And as you bring this down against the back, that will go right into that cavity the head was in. Right there. And then he just has a big tail. And what you're going to do with this is you're going to take this section here, push it up, it'll lock into place. Take this section right here, fold that in, bring that back, and then you fold this up against his back like that. And then this section just folds down right here behind his head. And there you go. And that's really cool how all that just compresses quite nicely. And are we done? I think we're done. Yes, we're done. We're done. And there you have Anarchus, or Kaon, in his robot's mode. Very nicely done. Very, very well done. Definitely, you know, looks like the end comic model there. I just really like how this figure came out. I think they did a great job with it. Very, very cool. So we're getting close here, so you can see the head sculpt. Nice head sculpt. Again, very, very IDW-esque. Nice paintwork here. You got some gold here on the sides. Got the gold on the crest. Nice silver on the face. Got his black dead eyes. Right there, you do got some nice gold detailing. Some silver right there in his chest. And overall, like I said, a very nice design. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Got all kinds of stuff in my throat. Forgive me. Again, you got some gold right here on the wrists. Got some little paint apps here and there. You got some gold right there. Silver. Got some silver toes. I am so sorry. I have all kinds of stuff in my throat. I don't know where it's coming from, but I wish it would leave. But anyway, overall, though, a very nice design. You even got some nice mold detail right here on the backpack that's picked out in silver, which is pretty cool. So, yeah, and again, I like how the backpack just compresses. It works really well. So there you have that. Very cool. Now, articulation-wise, his head is on a ball joint, so you can get some really good wiggly-waggly movement going on. He can look down. He can look up pretty far. The arms can do a full 360. They can go in and out. And these are on their own hinge right here, so you can angle these however you want. You do have a swivel at the elbow. You do have a double jointed elbow right there. The wrists are on a ball joint, so you get a little bit of wiggly waggly movement there. His waist is on a ball joint, which is really nice. So you get some nice wiggle waggle wiggle waggle. As far as rotation goes, just due to the way it's sculpted here, you know, it only allows but so much rotation, but you do get a lot of like side to side movements, forward and backward movement. You get basically an ab crunch going on there, which is pretty nice. These little hip skirts will move out of the way to accommodate the leg movements. The legs can go forward about that much. It can go back about that much because it bumps into the backpack. Outward movement, you get full outward movement there. No thigh swivel whatsoever. You do have this extra joint right here, which is for transformation, but you can use it for something. I don't know, maybe. You do have slightly under 90 degrees of bend at the knee. You do have that swivel underneath the knee right there. The feet, you do have quite a few joints to mess with here. You do have, you know, this little, the heel spurs on joint right here. Of course, you have this double joint here, so you can kind of move his toes up and down if you wish. And you do have some ankle tilt going on right there. So he's pretty poseable. There you have that. And you can take the little grabby claws here, and they will tab together. And you just rotate the legs back around. And you can see here there are some little red eyes painted up front, and you have his little drone dude. I keep wanting to call him a spider, but he's not really a spider because he only has six legs instead of eight. But, you know, yeah. Little spider dude. It's pretty cool. So you have that, and you can actually carry Anarchus's gun if you want to just use that tab. There's a slot right up top. You can just peg that right in. There you go. You can carry Anarchus's gun. You can, you know, angle that up and down however you wish. There you go. Which is pretty cool. So you have that. Of course, Anarchus can hold his gun. You just flip this down, plug it into his hand. He doesn't hold the gun super well. He actually does hold it kind of loosely. It just depends how he's holding it. Like, let's see, it's It's not really a dead solid grip, you know. It's yeah, that's one thing that's unfortunate, and you know, doesn't really happen with Mastermind toys, and that's really weird how he doesn't really hold his gun all that well. I mean, it's very odd, very odd. Kind of see it's definitely very loose, which is unfortunate. But if you don't like, you know, the little spider drone, you can just take him and, you know, fold him up. Like that, just fold up the legs, compact it all, real nice like, and there's a slot right there, and you can just take it and dab it in right there. There you go, stores on his arm, like that, if you want. Or another thing you can do, which is kind of fun, is split him in half here, and you take the legs and rotate them around again, like this. And like this, the joints on the legs are quite stiff. What you can do is you can just kind of take them and straighten them out, like that, and like that. The joints are stiff. There we go. Turn these around like that to straighten them all out. And you can take them and plug them in and give them kind of Wolverine claws. You know, why not? Dare I say, why not? You know, it's a thing. It's a thing you can do. Hey, why not? And you can also take them and just plug them in right back where they were in chair mode if you want. Again, for storage. You can do what you want with the legs. But, you know, again, there's various things you can do with it, or you can just, you know, take it and leave it off to the side altogether if you don't care for it at all. But, you know, you have options, is all I'm saying. You have options. It ain't nothing wrong with options. Am I right? Of course I'm right. Ain't nothing wrong with options. So, there you go. Get him back into his little... keep wanting to say spider mode, but he's not a spider. He's just a thing. He's a thing. So, there you have that in full comparison. Here he is with Voss here. We'll just get him standing up straight here. So there he is with Voss. You can see he's quite a bit taller than Voss. So, there you have that. Here he is with Impactor. Hey, you hold on to your gun, man. You hold on to your gun. You're a member of the DJD. You don't drop your weapon. So there he is with Impactor. You can see he's maybe a little bit shorter than Impactor. Right there. Here he is with Spectre. Just because he's there. There you go. There's how it scales with a Kamen Rider toy, in case anybody cares. Here he is with Combiner Wars Voyager Prime, just so you can see how he scales with the current Voyagers. And you can see a little bit shorter than Voyager Prime. So, there you go. So yeah, another cool figure by Mastermind, in my opinion. Definitely unfortunate. So I'm fortunate that I have to keep clearing my throat. So sorry. Again, I apologize for that. I don't know what's going on with me. But anyway, definitely unfortunate that one of the tabs broke on mine. But again, it doesn't seem... again, I've watched other reviews, and it doesn't seem like anybody else has had that problem. So again, it just seems like I just had a case of bad luck there. But whatever. It is what it is. It is unfortunate that he can't hold his gun that securely. That's one thing that is definitely... That shouldn't happen. These guys are better than that. They should, you know, have all these tolerances down. But, again, it is what it is. And of course, there are ways to fix them. You can always just kind of get some floor polish on that if you really want to. But there you go. Otherwise, I have to clear my throat and then my tongue stops working. See, it's just one of those days, man. It's just one of those days. It's just one of those days. But anyway. But overall, though, I do like the figure because, again, I love the IDW designs. So, you know, keep bringing them. keep bringing them. I want more. 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 I love these comic book designs, and I love that we're getting figures of them. And again, somebody get on an IDW Rodimus, please. 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 Come on. Why is it taking so long to do that? Why? I don't get it. I don't get it. I don't get it. Anyway. There you go. So, if you would like an Anarchist or any of Mastermind Creations' other offerings, you can always check out BigBadToyStore.com for availability. There will be a link in the description down below, so check that out. You can also check out my third-party Transformers playlist for any reviews you may have missed, also linked in the description down below, so check that out as well. And I think that's it. So don't forget to check out M-Games, check out Lori Plan, follow me on Twitter, all of that good stuff down in the description below. And I think that's pretty much all there is to say. So there is the Mastermind Creations Anarchist, and this is M-Go saying, remember, you don't stop playing because you grow old. You grow old because you stop playing. Be a geek. Be proud. Palm in your face. All right, Pax. There's only one way this plays out, so you might as well tell me what I want to know. Oh, yes, Megatron. I know exactly how this plays out. In about 2 seconds, I'm going to be out of this chair. Ha! Yeah, sure, whatever. You're funny, Pax. What the... How did he... How did you... It's easy, really. What the... It's all in the wrists. Ah, wait a second. How did you... Oh, you're good. I know. Recognize.